Hey guys, today I have 9 tips to help you speed up your Final Cut Pro 10 editing workflow. So yeah, let's get right to it. When gathering footage for a project, I start with a main folder and then I create subfolders for each of my different categories of media. Then on import, I make sure to have keywords from folders checked on, so folder names will automatically become keywords for all the imported media. I get instant organization, which makes it so much easier to find the footage I need. The J, K, and L shortcut keys are the best way to navigate through your footage. Pressing J plays clips in reverse, pressing K stops playback, and pressing L plays clips forward. You can also press the J or L keys multiple times, which keeps increasing the playback speed. And not only do these keys work in the browser, they work in the timeline too, and that makes them even more useful. Now that you know how to quickly skim through your footage in the browser, you can make selections too without taking your hands off the keyboard. Pressing I sets the start point for a range, pressing O sets the end point for a range, and then pressing the F key marks the selection as a favorite. Switching our browser view to favorites by pressing Ctrl F, you can see all the selections ready to be added to the storyline. And because keywords were added on import, it is even easier to find just the right clip. 3 keyboard shortcuts I use constantly while editing are zoom in, zoom out, and zoom to fit. Command plus zooms in, command minus zooms out, and shift Z zooms to fit. Now the great part about these shortcuts is they not only work in the timeline, but they also work in the browser and viewer windows too. You can add a title with a simple keyboard shortcut. Rather than clicking on titles and generators and searching for the title you want and then dragging it into the timeline, just press Ctrl T to add the default title to the primary storyline at the playhead. Want to use a different default title? Well, that's easy too. Just right-click on the title you want to set as default and choose Make Default Title. To quickly change the duration of a selection, press Ctrl D. The timecode value changes color and you can type in the new value. Timecode is displayed in hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. So for 2 seconds, type 200. For half a second, if you're working on a 24p timeline, type in 12, which is 12 frames, or half a second. The quickest way to duplicate an asset on the timeline is to use Option Drag. Hover the pointer over the asset you want to duplicate, hold down the Option key, and click Drag to replicate it. Want to do a bunch of things? No problem. Just make a selection and use Option Drag to duplicate multiple items at the same time. It's quick and it works with any asset in the timeline. The easiest way to add a marker at the playhead is to hit the M key. Hit the M key twice and it brings up more options so you can enter a descriptive name or even change the marker type. I use this often for creating to-do markers, which help to remind me of tasks I need to complete. To-do markers are great because they show up in red in the timeline and they stay red until you mark them as complete. To quickly see and jump to incomplete markers, open the timeline index, select tags, and then select incomplete to-do markers. And finally, rather than adding effects and making adjustments clip by clip, you can duplicate your effort with a simple copy paste. Select the clip from which you want to copy adjustments and hit Command C. Select the clip or range of clips to which you want to apply the adjustments and hit Shift Command V. A dialog pops up showing you what attributes are about to be applied so you can make changes if necessary. This is a quick and easy method for applying the same adjustments to a range of clips. Well, that's it for this one, guys. I hope you learned a trick or two to help speed up your Final Cut Pro 10 editing workflow. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.